Bill Davis from the USA trying to cause an upset against the reigning champion John Parr, who's looking forward to defending his title.
I feel good. I feel I'm ready to play and defend in a reasonable fashion and do myself justice, which maybe during the rest of the year I haven't. So I feel better for it now. I looked at the odds and the expectation isn't there, so the pressure's off me. I'm just going to do what I can do, and I think I can surprise people again and again and again. So that's where I am. I can certainly say that the World Championship is, for whatever reason, I think it's because it's the one tournament where everyone's sort of nervous. I think it's the place you will see dark horses. And there will be a story. I'm hoping it's not in my section. It's one step at a time, so hopefully I can do well against Bill, and then I can look at the rest of the tournament. If I can just stay in, be a surprise.
See, John McDonald.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're live at the Alexandra Palace, London. Ladbrokes.com. World Darts Championships brought to you by the PDC and live on Sky Sports. Let's meet our players for our first round action. Would you firstly please welcome from the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia, it's Bill
Shepherd 7-2, the first year the World Darts came to the Ali Pali. The defence of that title starts now on day one of the 2009 competition. The commentators, Rod Harrington and Sid Woodall.
Thank you, Dave. It's a little on facts, but the first dart board that went across to the American continent was taken on board the Mayflower by the Pilgrim Fathers. So that's how the Canadians and the Americans picked up our wonderful game. And as tradition has it, Rod, the champ plays on night one to defend his title.
Yeah, it certainly does. And John Parr, funny 42 years of age, but he's looking really slim, he's looking mean. He hasn't had the greatest of years after winning that championship last year, but he really has come into a bit of form the last month, 6 weeks. He's been doing a lot of hard work on the practice board, and I think he's right in what he said, Sid. He's someone to be reckoned with this week.
Well, we'll see. Crowd in good voice here in top of Muswell Hill. Champ started playing when he was 21. Part, but Davis here from the Freedom Town of Philadelphia. Second appearance, 2007. Circus Tavern lost Andy Jenkins. Game on!
Well, he's a solid player, is Bill Davis. Nothing will upset him. He'll play his own game all the way through, so it doesn't matter what John Park hits. It's just a question if Bill Davis's game is good enough to beat John Park. I just think John Park is going to come out all guns a-blazing.
Well, I think this year's competition, he has to. Last year he started with a 94 against Losberg, 100 against Suljevic, and that sort of level, an average of nearly 94 was good enough to get him to the final and a win. I think, guys, getting to the final here is going to need 10 points on top of that, Rod. We're going to see 103 averages to win this one over the next 13 match days.
Yeah, I think you're right, Sid. Last year we see a lot of the top players not really on form. They went down early. And it left it open for John Park to do a very professional job, just game on game, took his time, beat the player that was in front of him, didn't worry about the final until he got there. And he thought Christmas, he had another Christmas present, I should say.
Not yet finding the range on that 60, nice last dart. Say, this lad done very well in American tournaments with the PDC. Very cool customer from Philadelphia. Nice adjustment to the 60. And we look at that part. Trying to get back to the form of 2005 when it, the match play, retail at 16-11. He's going to need that kind of form.
Well, he's certainly one of the players who can play this big stage. He loves the big crowd. He loves this stage here, this John Park. And he's been around long enough and he's beaten everybody in the game, so he isn't scared of anything. Bill wants double 10 for the first leg. It's way off and he knows it. He just needs to put this inside, but he's got plenty of time.
70.
Well, he's got plenty of time because John Park's at least 9 darts away.
One of the greatest counters the game's ever known after Harry Christer himself. My friend Rod Arrington here. Twice World Matchplay Champion, former world number one. Crowd very expectant here, Rod.
Well, that's a great result there from John Park. Put some pressure on this double five. Well, that's a brilliant mark. You wouldn't expect Bill Davis to miss this now.
Game's in the first leg.
World champ then. Slight crown. An academic career at Oshawa University, was going to go into business studies, but then left the financial angels and joined the Tungsten Ticklers.
Well, if I remember rightly, John Park used the treble 19 really well last year, and that's one thing that a lot more players have to do. As soon as you cover up that treble 20 bid, go for the open target. And if you can do that, you pick up the extra points, that gives you extra darts and a double.
Well, let's just check out what science says about the pass rule with flight count 1,000. 1,000 frames a second. Looks like a slightly earlier release that. So that means dart will get a higher trajectory.
Yeah, you're exactly right, Sid. Perfect example there from the camera. John Park, early release, and the dart goes higher. Here we have Bill Davis. And again, Bill Davis releases a little bit hard, a little bit early, and his dart has a bigger rainbow than, say, Phil Taylor's would or James Wade.
40.
There you go. Day one, and already Rod Arrington adding to the palette of darts jargon. I love it. The rainbow shot. Love it. Wow. Understacker needed. Hardest shot in the game.
Yeah, that was a great third dart. You can actually see how the other two flights guided the third one in. John Park, is he going to slam this third one in there? Well, Davis on 81 to go 2-0 up in this first set.
World champ averaging the 84. Challenger from across the pond. Wait for it, averaging 106. Game on in Ali Pally.
Well, he's got to go 12 ball. There's no other route here. He's got to go 12 for the bullseye. Double 13 for 2-0. What a shot this will be.
Bingo!